Now we are going to see the lesson that I can't climb trees anymore. The story was written by Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond was born on 19th May 1934. He was famous for his children's literature. Renowned means famous. He got Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 for his book Our Trees Still Grow in Dekra. He got Padma Shri Award in 1999 and Padma Bhushan Award in 2014. He wrote 500 short stories, essays and novels. His popular novel was The Blue Umbrella. It was made into a film. The film got Best Children's Film Award in 2007. The story is about a middle-aged person reminiscing his young age. Do you have trees before your home? Have you ever tried swinging from a tree? Have you ever climbed up a tree to pluck fruits? It is interesting to swing in a tree and pluck fruits from a tree. For children, read the story given below. Find out why the visitors feel that he can't climb trees anymore. He stood on the grass verge by the side of the road and looked over the garden wall at the old house. He stood on the edge of the road and looked over the garden wall at the old house. He saw a old house over the garden wall. It hadn't changed much. The house hadn't changed much. The old house built with solid blocks of granite wasn't altered at all. But there was a new house and a new outhouse and there were few trees. But It was glad to see. He was glad to see that the jackfruit tree still stand at the side of the building, casting its ashes on the wall. He saw a jackfruit tree standing near a house. Its shadow was fall on the walls of the house. Casting means throwing its shadow on the house. He remembered his grandmother's saying. Remembered means recall. He recalled his grandmother's saying. His grandmother said that a blessing rests on the house where the shadow of the tree falls. What are the blessings come from the trees? The trees gives fresh air. The tree fresh air for breathing. The trees gives fruits. The tree gives shadows, coolness. So we got blessing from the trees. And so the present owner must also be receiving the tree blessing. The present owner also received the blessing of the jackfruit tree. At the spot where he stood, there had once been a standstill. He is standing at a place. There was a standstill. And as a boy, he would swing on it. When he was a boy, he turned on the standstill. Standstill is a mechanical gate, rolling gate. Going round and round until he was kitty. He whirling in the turnstile until he was giddy. Dizzy means giddy. Now the turnstile was gone. Now there is no turnstile. The opening walled up. Wall was raised in that places. Tall hollyhocks grew on the other side of the wall. Tall tree was hollyhocks is a tree. Yes, tree. Hollyhock. Tall tree was grown in that place. It was here. What are you looking at? A voice heard. It was a disembodied voice at first. This is a hesitating voice. A hesitating voice heard. What are you looking at? Moment later, a girl stood framed between the door, between dark red hollyhocks, staring at the man. A girl standing near a hollyhock tree and looking the middle-aged man. She was only 12 or 13, with lively eyes and long black hair. Disembodied means hesitating. Staring means looking. She was only 12 or 13. The girl was 12 or 13 years old. His eyes was lively. She has a long black hair. I am looking at the house. It is yours, he asked. The old man asked that he was looking at the house. If it was hers. No, it was my father's. Why do you want to buy it? The girl said that it was her father's house. Why? If he wanted to buy the house. And what does your father do? The man asked what his father did. He is only a colonel. She said that he is a colonel. Colonel means army officer. Only a colonel. Well, he should have been a brigadier by now. She said that her father should have been a brigadier by then. Brigadier is a high rank in army officer. The man burst out laughing. The man laughed. It's not funny, she said. It's not a joke, she said. Even mummy says he should be in a brigadier. Also, her mummy said that her father should be in a brigadier. It was on the tip of his lung to make a witty remark. He wanted to make a funny remark. Witty means funny. Perhaps that's why he is still a colonel. But he did not want to give offense. Often mean insult. He didn't want to insult her. They stood on either side of the wall, appraising each other. Appraising means estimating. The girl and the middle-aged man standing on either side of the wall and estimating each other. Do you want to buy it? The girl asked the man. If he wanted to buy the house. The man asked the girl asked the man if he wanted to buy it. The man said no. Well, she said, if you don't want to buy the house, why are you looking at? She asked him that if he didn't want to buy the house, what he was looking at. It used to live here 20 years ago. The man said that he lived 20 years ago in this house. As a boy, as a young man, he was living in the house. And then my grandmother died and we sold the house and went away. After his grandmother's death, they sold the house and went away. She was silent for a while, taking in this message. Information means message. After hearing this message, he was silent. Then she said, "And you had like to buy it back now, but you don't have the money." He did not look very prosperous. You had the girl said that the man wanted to buy the house, but he hadn't money. He didn't look very prosperous. Prosperous means wealthy. He didn't look very wealthy. No, I wasn't thinking of buying it back. Wanted to see it again, that's all. How long have you lived in it? The man said that he didn't want to buy the house, but simply wanted to see the house. How long have you lived in it? The man asked to the girl how long she had lived in it. Only 3 years, she smiled. Would you like to come in and look more closely? The girl asked him to come in. Wouldn't your parents mind? The man asked that. Wouldn't her parents wouldn't mind? They have gone to the club. They won't mind. I am allowed to bring my friend home. Elderly friend like me. They have gone to the club. The girl's parents gone to the club. They won't mind. They don't tell anything. Don't tell anything. I am allowed to bring my friends home. They allowed to bring her friends home. Even elderly friends like me? The man asked that. The man was a elderly person, middle-aged person. The parents allowed the elderly parents also. The man asked to the girl. How old are you? The girl asked him, how old are you? How old he was? The girl asked him how old he was. Oh, just middle-aged, but feeling young. The man said that he was middle-aged person, but feel young today. And to prove it, he decided he had climbed over the wall instead of going round to the gate. The man climbed on the wall. He got up on the wall all right, but had to rest there breathing heavily. He climbed on the wall, but he breathed heavily. Middle-aged man on flying trapeze. He muttered to himself. Muttered mean murmured. Trapeze mean acrobat in circus. He said to himself. Middle-aged man on the flying circus. I will help you, she said, and gave him her hands. The girl wanted to help him. He slithered down into the flower bed, shattering the stem of a hollyhock. The man slid down into the flower bed. He broke the stem of the hollyhock. Slithered means slide, shatter means broke. As they walked across the grass, he spotted a stone bench under a mango tree. He saw a stone bench under a mango tree. It was the bench on which his grandmother used to rest. On that bench, his grandmother used to rest. When she was tired of burning rose bushes and bougainvillea. Burning means trimming. Bougainvillea means a climbing plant. He trimming rose bushes and climbing plant. After trimming, grandmother rest on the stone bench. Let's just sit here, he said. He wanted to sit there. I don't want to go inside. He didn't want to go inside the house. She sat beside him on the bench. She sat near him. They were silent for some time. The man closed his eyes and remembered other times the music of the piano and chiming of the grandmother clack, the constant twitter of budgerigar on the veranda, his grandfather cranking up the old car. Chiming means ringing sound. Twitter means ripping of bats. Budgerigar means parrot. Cranking means snorting. The man closed his eyes and recalled the young age. The music of the piano, the ringing of grandmother's clack, the constant stripping of parrot on the veranda, his grandmother starting up the old car. I used to climb the jackfruit tree, he said, opening his eyes. He opened his eyes and said that he climbed the jackfruit tree when he was young. Do you want to climb it again? My parents won't mind. She said that. She asked him if he wanted to climb it again. No, no, not after climbing the garden wall. After climbing the garden wall, he breathed heavily, so he didn't want to climb on the jackfruit tree. Let's just sit here for a few minutes and talk. I mentioned the jackfruit tree because it was a favorite place. The jackfruit tree was his liked place. Do you see that thick branch stretching out over the roof? He asked her to see the thick branch extending over the roof. Stretching means extending. Halfway along it, there was a small hole in which I used to keep some of my treasure. He said that there was a hollow in the branch and keep some of valuable things in it. What kind of treasure? What kind of valuables? The girl asked. Oh, nothing were very valuable. Marbles I had won, a book I wasn't supposed to read, a few old coins I had collected. The valuables are marbles, books and coins. I was a bit of a crow, you know, collecting bright things and putting them away. The crows collecting the bright things, like the man when he was young collecting a bright things and putting into the hollow of the jackfruit tree. Well, not my grandfather exactly, because he was my grandfather's iron grass. Well, not my grandfather exactly, because he was British and the iron cross was German decoration awarded for bravery during the war, the First World War. When my grandfather fought in France, he got it from German soldiers. There was an iron cross in the hollow. It was his grandfather's iron cross. It was given to his grandfather by a German soldiers. During the First World War, his grandfather fought bravely. So the German soldier gave him the Iron Cross. Paramveer Chakra is the highest award given to Indian soldiers. It was begun in 1950 and given to 21 soldiers. Out of 21, 14 soldiers are death. After the death, 14 soldiers. After the death for the 14 soldiers, the Paramveer Chakra awards are given. Inception means begin. Posthumous means after death. Do you still have it? No, he said, looking her in his eyes. I left it in jackfruit tree. The medal was given by his grandfather to him. The girl asked the old man if he still had it. The man said that no, looking her in the eyes. I left it in the jackfruit tree. The old man said that he left the iron cross in the jackfruit tree. You left it in the tree? She asked. Yes, I was so excited at a time, packing and saying goodbye to people and thinking about the ship I was going to sail on that, I simply forgot all about it. Excited means thrilled. Forget means unremembered. He is excited in packing up and say goodbye to the people. He forget and remember to take the iron cross. She quietly said, it may still be there in the hollow part of the branch. She said that the iron cross was still in the hollow of the branch. Yes, he said, it's 25 years, but it may still be there unless someone found it. Unless someone take it, the iron cross was still in the hollow tree. Would you like to go and look? The girl asked him if he would like to go and look the iron cross. I can't climb trees anymore. The man said that he would not climb trees now. If you can't, I will go and see. You just sit here and wait for me. The girl said that if he hadn't climbed on a tree, she would go and see that. I have found it, she cried. I have found something. The girl cried that she had found it. And now barefoot, she ran breathlessly towards King. In her outstretched hands, a rusty old medal. She ran towards him and extended his hand. His hand have rusty old medal. He took it from her and turned it over on his palm. He took the iron cross and see that. Is it the iron cross? He asked eagerly. Yes, he said, there, that is it. He said that it was that iron cross. Now I know why you came. You wanted to see if it was still in the tree. The girl said that she knew why he was come. He wanted to see the iron cross still in the tree. You may be right. I am not really sure why I came, but you can keep the cross. You found it after all. The man said that you can keep the cross. The girl found the cross, so the man given the cross to the girl. No, you keep it, it yours. The girl said that the cross was him. But it could have remained in the tree For another 25 years, if you hadn't climbed up to look for it, but it would have remained in the tree for another 25 years if you hadn't climbed up to look for it. The man said that if the girl hadn't climbed up and take the iron cross still in the tree for another 25 years. But if you hadn't come back again, the girl said that if the man hadn't come back again, the iron cross was still in the hollow. On the right day, at the right time, and with the right person, he said, getting up and placing the medal in her hands, it was in the grass I came for, it was my youth. The man said that on the right day, right time, with the right person. Right person, sir? The girl. He said, getting up and placing the medal in her hand. Right person is the girl. The girl take the iron cross. So, he give to the girl the cross. If he taken the cross with him, the girl forget the middle-aged man. If the girl keep the iron cross, the girl always remember the middle-aged person. So the man give the cross to the girl. It was in the cross I came for. I was my youth. The man said that he wasn't come for take the cross. He was come for seeing his truth. Remembering his truth, recall his truth. She didn't understand that. She didn't realize that. But she walked with him to the gate and waited where the road turned. He looked back and waved to her. Then he quickened his step and moved briskly towards the bus stop, where the round He didn't realize the words of the man, but he go with him to the gate and say goodbye to him. The man walked quickly towards the bus stop. There was sprightliness in his step. There was a liveliness in his step. He feel happy in his heart. The mango-scented summer breeze made the blood course in his vein, and he forget for a moment that he couldn't climb there anymore. The fragrance come from the mango tree in the breeze. It mingled in the blood course in his vein. It mingled in the blood course in his vein. And he forget for the moment that he could not climb tree anymore. He feel very young. After breathing the fragrance come from the mango tree, he feel happy and feel like young man. Thank you.